I love to shoot at people that are already shooting at me, and I love bunkering people. Bunkering people is my favorite.
Jacob on the field is one of those guys who's really aggressive. If he gets punched in the face, he's gonna punch back.
He is such a dominant gunfighter. He relies on that a lot, which, you know, works in his favor, I would say, the majority of the time.
You could put him as a cornerstone on any team and build a great team around him.
Listen up.
Tampa! Tampa! Tampa!
Tampa 3, 1, 2, 3, 3! Let's go, baby.
Let's go, boys.
I would describe my style of play as always aggressive. I'm always looking for the push, looking for the move, looking for an opening. And then if I have somebody shooting at me, I like to shoot back at them. So, like, gunfighting is my expertise. You know, I love to shoot at people that are already shooting at me. And I love bunkering people. Bunkering people is my favorite.
With Jacob, the one thing I'll give that kid is he plays with more heart than most people in paintball. He's a crazy controlled aggression guy. Sometimes I have to put the brakes on him because he's trying to go a little bit too fast. He's come a long way. Obviously, I've been gone for, you know, 3 or 4 years. He went from being a short fuse firecracker that caused all kinds of issues to somebody you could put him as a cornerstone on any team and build a great team around him.
He is such a dominant gunfighter. He relies on that a lot, which, you know, works in his favor, I would say, the majority of the time.
Jacob on the field is one of those guys who's really aggressive. If he gets punched in the face, he's gonna punch back. Like, he's one of those guys, say he gets shot off the break or something like that, he's not one of those guys that says, oh, they got me. It's, I'm gonna go get this mother.
Every time I'm playing aggressive, I always have, you know, a goal in my mind, a bunker that I want to get to, because I know that if I get to that bunker, then I can kill people across the field. So I have that in mind, that goal, that vision. But sometimes, you know, you just get caught in a gap, some dude shooting across, or they set a trap on you, and sometimes it just doesn't work out. You fall short of your goal. But you know, that's what's good about X-Ball. You get that next point to do it all over again.
Play more as a team, you know, communicate a little bit more, talk to the players next to you, and just realize that you don't have to go out there and get every kill. Like, our team is based off of a bunch of superstars, not just one person. So, you know, you don't have to do all the work, big guy. Like, just let us get our kills too.
He gets a little too aggressive at times, in my opinion. He'll try and fight too much because of his passion and the way his mental mindset is. If you're going to try me, I'm going to come right back at you, and he'll fight you so hard, sometimes that'll work against him, where he will get caught in a gunfight because he's trying to push too hard at times.
When you swing out wide to those, like, 50 bricks, you know, it's heads up right down the line. You can see straight down the line gunfight. And then it's also that inside or down the wire, you know, you just have a seam. You break it open and stick the guy that's like in your mirror, basically. And I like fields like that because if they get there, they're a threat to your team. And I feel like I'm protecting my brothers by going to take him out, you know, before he shoots them in the back.
When Jacob's on fire, he is one of the best players in the league. No questions asked. I mean, the kid's been, I've played around Jacob and with him since he was probably 12 years old, 13 years old. I mean, I've known him since he was a little kid. He'd go out to the field and Frank Connell would pound his head into the dirt over and over and over. And I think that's where he got that mindset of, all right, I'm going to come back at you. And then he obviously has Jason smashing his head in when he's a little kid and really just doing everything he can to bring him up and make him a tough guy. And that's what he's turned into. And he'll come back at you full force no matter what.
It's adrenaline pumping through your veins. Like you're running somebody down and at any moment he can just pop over the top and he has you wide open, you know. But then he could also be looking the other way and you go and you see a back, a pack, a head, everything. I have a lot of faith in my team. That's why I'm that guy to just go and you know, kill people. I know I'm gonna die a lot. If I can get 2 kills a game, I know that my team can clean up 3 bodies, 4-on-3, easy. I think pretty much 100% of the time.
Hey, Snake! Get tequila!
As far as making Jacob a better player, what does Jacob need to do to be the best player Jacob can be? He needs to lose 15 pounds. He needs to get in better shape. He's a naturally gifted paintball player. Obviously, his pedigree's unquestionable with his brother out there and stuff, and those two push each other really hard. He's a great player. He's a great shot. He just needs to get in better shape.
The best thing that Jacob could do is continue to practice. You know, now he's traveling for work, so it's not like he's just sitting at home playing paintball with me all the time. He needs to go out and check out some different fields wherever he ends up, you know, working, and keep focusing on that cardio because, you know, we're going to be a short roster team and we want him to be able to play every point.
Hey, I got shot running and shooting 100 on the dive. I think if we just sprint it, we'll be good, yeah.
Damage needs to learn that everyone on this team can shoot any other person on the other side of the field and that they don't all need to do everything themselves and that we need to play as a team, communicate, and drag it out. When we take teams down, you know, the long road of, you know, come and get a style of paintball or even, you know, let us hunker in, we do not usually lose those points, and that's just the way Damage was created back in the day, and the majority of us are back and we still have that down in us, but you know, a lot of us like to try to take all the weight upon us and put it on our shoulders and go, and we don't need to do that. We need to play as an entire family.
The path for Damage to get better is going to come down to a controlled aggression, working together, having a fire behind you, but being able to control the fire. I think Joey Blute's going to help with that. I think Joey Blute's going to, he's known everybody on the team for a very long time, and he knows how to bring the best out in the people, but he can be very aggressive about it. But if the team really gets it, the right mindset, works together, does their drills, because I think that's one of the things that they need to do more than playing 5-on-5s and stuff like that at practice, and really get back to fundamentals, I think Damage can be a great top 3 team consistently again, but they have to do the work to get there.
From day one when I came back, I just told all of them, you gotta buy in. You gotta believe in each other. You gotta be 100% into this. You can't half-ass this. You can't do that under the breath bullshit. You can't come out of the game no matter what happens acting the fool. There's gotta be a hierarchy. There's gotta be a pecking order. If you follow the pecking order and you trust the process and you trust in each other, the sky's the limit. I mean, this team, we won more paintball in the 9 years when I was running it before than any other team in paintball ever has or ever will. We won 7 events in a row, 4 7 man and 3 PSPs. You're not gonna ever see that again. With that being said, and it was damn near with the same roster we have now, With that being said, the only way we're going to get back to that is if everyone buys in 100%, believes in each other, trusts each other. This is a team sport. You have to go out and play like a team. So I believe that that he is buying in. He's definitely still got a little bit of a short fuse, and he's still figuring out how to control the anger issues. But Jacob is a completely and totally different person than when I left, and he'll be a completely and totally different person before World Cup.
It'll take damage to trust each other to become a winning franchise again. We're actually, as I could see in that last match, it's developing faster than I thought it would develop. But everyone, like, I don't know, man. Like, if I was way up in enemy territory. I should have got bunkered, and I just didn't even look on the wire. I wasn't even scared. I was ready to take him in the back, but I knew I had somebody watching me. So it's, you know, it's just that when we develop that and we go back to trusting each other and knowing that, hey, if it's a 3-on-4, we're the 3, they're the 4, trusting your brothers to get that kill to even up the game, you know, and or trust that guy to shoot 2 people real quick, and now you got the 1-body advantage. It's just, we got to go back to that, to where, to thinking where the point is never over until they shoot the last body. And that's how damage used to be. Back in the day, we never even blew a buzzer. We would let the last guy get bunkered because half of the time that guy would pull off a 1-on-2, 1-on-3. It was just, we were good. We had trust, you know, we had faith. And that's what it's going to take.